Hello, Dr. Cisse covering anatomy and physiology. Today I will talk about gene expression. Let's pretend you have a family home. You have a grandmother in the home. You have a neighbor whose name is Steve. Steve came to the house and knocked at the door. Your grandma came to the door and Steve said to your grandmother that you have a neighbor whose name is Ethan who wants to eat cake today. Your grandma said, of course I'll make cake for Ethan today. Your grandma walked to the kitchen to go look for her recipe books. She has 23 pairs of those recipe books in the kitchen. She called you to come open the book. She said, book number 19 out of 23 pairs, so the total is 46 books, and she said, book 19, open the book 19 and find page 520. There is a recipe to make cake there. You came and opened the book and grandma said, hey, no, you can't move my book out of the kitchen. The recipe has to stay in the kitchen, but you can make a copy of it. So you grab a piece of paper and a pen and you read the information in the book and you wrote down on the piece of paper. You have the recipe, flour, egg, milk, sugar, and salt. Then you called your brother Tyrone. You told Tyrone to come to bring you the ingredients to make the cake. So Tyrone went to the cabinet, picked up the flour, the egg, the milk, the sugar, and the salt, and brought them to the table, to the counter. And he mixed them. He mixed them, and grandma is the old-fashioned grandma. She doesn't have her stove in the kitchen. She has the stove in another part of the house. So Tyrone mixed all the ingredients and took them to the stove and put them in the stove. 15 minutes later, the cake was baked, it was ready, and your grandma sent it to Ethan so Ethan can eat it. Now, this is a beautiful story, right? So think about it. The neighbor coming to your house, knocking at the door, your grandma opening the door, the neighbor telling the grandma to make cake, right? In order for your grandma to bake cake, she has to have a recipe. She went to the kitchen, she looked at the books, 23 pairs of book. She called you, you opened the book, you saw the recipe, flour mixed with the milk, with sugar and salt. You came and made a copy of it. You called your brother came and brought all the ingredients, you mixed them. Brother put in the oven, it was baked 15 minutes, the cake was made. So now let's talk about this in a biological way, right? So let's pretend this is your grandma's house. It has a door and it has a kitchen. Steve, your neighbor, came to the door and asked your grandma. Your grandma walked to the door and asked Steve, and Steve said, hey, I want you to bake cake. Your grandma walked to the kitchen. So this is the kitchen here. Walk to the kitchen and come find books. How many books again? 23 pairs of books. So that's got a total of 46 books. So there are 46 books here. Grandma picked one of the book number 19. And grandma told you to come open the book. So you came and opened the book. When you saw the book, you made a copy. So you grabbed a piece of paper. So you wrote down the recipe from the book to the piece of paper. And then you took the piece of paper out. And find your brother, Tyrone, T-I, Tyrone. And then you told Tyrone to go bring the ingredients to make the cake. So on the recipe, so this recipe kind of moved here now. You had flour, egg, milk, sugar, and salt. So Tyrone went to the cabinet and picked up all these ingredients and mixed them together. After it was mixed, he put them in the pan and took it to your grandma's oven. Now, grandma didn't have the oven in the kitchen because grandma is old-fashioned. The oven was in the house somewhere. So Tyrone took all the ingredients and put in the oven here. So this is the oven. And then baked the cake. In 15 minutes, it was ready and it was taken, shipped out to Ethan, your neighbor. So basically, Steve is the one who told Grandma that Ethan needs cake. Grandma went to the kitchen, find the recipe book, called you to read the book, to make a copy. You made a copy. You called your brother to bring all the ingredients. He did. You mix them, you put it in the oven, you bake it. So the cake is ready. It was shipped to Ethan. In biology, how do we explain this? Steve is the stimulus. Stimulus. What is the stimulus? A stimulus is anything that can excite a cell, that can tell the cell to do something, the stimulus. Then the door here are the receptors. What do? They receive information, they receive the stimulus. Then your grandma who came to the door is a second messenger, or also called the regulatory protein. So grandma is a what? A regulatory protein. Regulatory protein. What does it do? It regulates. Grandma kind of handles things in the house. She tells people what to do, right? Now grandma walked to the kitchen. In this case, the kitchen is the nucleus. Kitchen is what? Nucleus. He uses a door to come into the nucleus. When grandma came to the nucleus to find the recipe, she has to go through the pile of books. The pile of books together is called the DNA. All the books together is what? The DNA. The DNA is also divided into pieces. On those pieces are called chromosomes. And the chromosome number 19 happens to be the one that has the recipe for the cake. And you are called, you came to read the recipe in the book, in the DNA, so that you can make a copy. And your name is polymerase. What is a polymerase? It's an enzyme. Polymerase. You are what? An enzyme. What is an enzyme? It's a chemical catalyzer. It's a chemical, a protein that makes things happen. So you will make things happen. So you, as polymerase, an enzyme, read the book and you made a copy of the recipe in the book. And this copy is called the mRNA. What does the M stand for? Messenger RNA, ribonucleic acid. Why it's called messenger? Because you only take the message. You transcribe the message. You take the message. You wrote the message. When you wrote the message was on that piece of paper. It was shipped out of the nucleus, the kitchen, to come to the cytoplasm, the rest of the cell. When it got here, now you've had to find the ingredients to mix them to make the cake. You cannot do that yourself. You have to call your brother, Tyrone. Tyrone is a tRNA. What does T stand for? Transfer. What does it transfer? It just transfers the ingredients for the cake to the place where the cake needs to be baked. And that place is called the ribosome. The oven is what? Ribosome. This blue one, ribosome. So the ribosome is a machine on top of the rough ER, endoplasmic reticulum, whose job is to make the protein, in this case, bake the cake. So the ingredient put together by Tyrone, tRNA, was sent to the ribosome, the oven, to be baked, to make a cake. And that cake is called protein. This cake is what? Protein. And that protein was shipped out to Ethan for Ethan to eat it. To conclude, to summarize all this, this circle is a cell, just like a home. A stimulus comes to the cell to excite the receptor. This receptor has to talk to the regulatory protein, in this case, your grandmother. And that regulatory protein has to go into the nucleus to find the gene, the information of the recipe in the book, which is the DNA. And the DNA is divided into pieces. Each piece is called a chromosome. And each chromosome will have a specific type of information, in this case, information to bake a cake. For example, page 15 might find something to make spaghetti. Page 21 might find something to make pasta. Every page of the book has information called the genie, has the specific information. In this case, it happened to be 19, which has the recipe to bake the cake. Then your grandma called you an enzyme polymerase to come read the information and write down the copy. And the piece of paper you write down the thing is called the mRNA. And that mRNA is just the information, just a copy of the DNA made by the polymerase, which is an enzyme. But that polymerase cannot do more with that. It has to call the tRNA, Tyron, to come mix all the ingredients to make the cake. And those ingredients are placed in the oven ribosome that is all located on the rough ER. And that ribosome will bake the cake, and that cake is the protein, and the protein will be shipped out to go to the neighbor who needs to eat that cake. Now, in the next video, I'll be explaining in detail how the DNA is kind of used to make this in detail, okay? All right, thank you very much, and I'll see you in class.